Hi, I am Safi and this is theelectronics.com. Which is the most secured messaging app in terms of keeping all the information you send across using the service? We look at three major services: WhatsApp, Telegram and Signal. Which one will you use? It is your choice after all. Before going into the security aspect, let's have a look at the platform. WhatsApp. WhatsApp undoubtedly has become the largest messaging medium. Founded in 2009 by Jan Koum and Brian Acton, the app became a part of Facebook in 2014. So it's been around for a long time now. 2 billion users in 180 countries are using the app, according to WhatsApp's website. With the internet becoming easily available for the masses, users shifted from SMS Messenger and migrated to WhatsApp. Text, photos, videos, docs, location, voice calls, video calls, then there is WhatsApp desktop. It's all possible with WhatsApp. Now coming to Telegram. Telegram started in 2013, first for iOS, then for Android. It is supported by Pavel Durov and Nikolai, two brothers. Telegram's developers were initially from St. Petersburg, but shifted out of Russia due to local technology regulations. After trying Berlin, London, Singapore, the development team now operates out of Dubai. Telegram is cloud-based, so you can access messages from various devices which get synced with the cloud. Here as well, photos, videos, docs, the size of file size you can share is up to 2 GB. Well, you can also create groups for up to 2 lakh users. Now coming to Signal. Signal was launched in 2014, but the popularity became in during 2019 and 2020. It succeeded Redfone, an encrypted voice calling app, and the Text Secure, an encrypted texting program. Then there is a history in between, which includes formation of Signal Foundation to support its growth. Signal came to light when the world's richest man and Tesla CEO Elon Musk recently tweeted asking users to use Signal just after news of WhatsApp updating its terms and services came out. After the tweet, Signal tops the chart on various app stores, just ahead of WhatsApp. Now, let's look into the security aspect. First, WhatsApp. WhatsApp offers E2E or end-to-end encryption for all your information. Messages, calls, photographs, or whatever you share. However, once you back up your info locally or on cloud, this version is no longer encrypted. The metadata, that is the information about the data you are sharing, is also not encrypted. This means that while what you shared is veiled, it does reveal the identities and time of communication of the two communicators. Now coming to Telegram. In Telegram, you get E2E encryption once you enable its secret chats feature. In order to have your data accessed, an entity, say an authority, will have to procure court order through a legal route. When it comes to group chats, you don't get encryption as it is only available for single user information communication. Now coming to Signal. Signal is totally free. This app is run by a non-profit organization built by American cryptographer Moxie Merrill Spike, who is also the CEO of Signal. It has end-to-end encryption based on the Signal protocol. It means no third party or even Signal can read your messages. The Signal protocol is open source, which is another good thing. Signal does not support third-party backups either, which is actually a good thing. All data remains stored locally on the device, and if you do lose access to the device and try to set up Signal on another phone, your previous chat history is lost. It supports group features with a maximum of 150 members. It has recently added group video calls. The app also supports regular video and audio calls, which are also end-to-end encrypted. Apart from these basic features, the app also boasts of disappearing messages and cross-platform availability. The key priority of Signal is user privacy, which is why the app doesn't collect any user data as per the privacy labels provided on the App Store. The app only stores your phone number or contact information. When it comes to data collection, this is one of the most minimal apps out there. Now, which one will you choose? It's your choice. Like, share, and subscribe our digital platforms to never miss any updates from theelectronics.com. Thanks for watching.